You might have heard the news. The newer Amtrak Acelas are finally debuting in 2025, after years of delays. But it's not just the Acela. Why does it feel like the Americas are stuck in the past when it comes to rail? And I'm not talking just about the United States. But what if it didn't have to be this way? What if we could build the best high-speed corridors across North, Central and South America? Welcome folks, I am your host, DD Capybara, a rail enthusiast with a twist. Let's get things started with Cascadia, one of the most promising regions of high-speed rail in North America. The Pacific Northwest is a visually stunning region, but also economically important. Imagine hopping on a slick train in Seattle and arriving in Vancouver or Portland in just over a few hours. No gridlock highways, no airport hustle, this dream could be closer than you think. The proposed Cascadia corridor would connect these three major cities with trains zooming at high speeds. But why does this matter? These cities are already tech and trade hubs. Connecting them seamlessly would streamline regional economic growth, allowing business folk to commute easily. This is my proposed route, starting Portland, Oregon, move to Seattle, and end in Vancouver, Canada, connecting the Pacific Northwest together. In fact, this same route is currently being planned and it would be operating in speeds up to 250 miles per hour. It would be following the I-5 from Portland into Vancouver, British Columbia. Will this happen in real life? Likely not. But a capybara can dream, right? Building here is not easy, there are hurdles. Funding, cross-border issues, and political coordination, getting people to agree on something. But if Cascadia can overcome these challenges, it could set a gold standard for high-speed rail, not just in America, but in the Americas. Moving south towards Always Sunny California, where high-speed rail is finally under construction. The California High-Speed Rail, or CASHR project, has faced its fair share of delays and budget overruns, but it remains a game changer for the region. The current route is Merced to Bakersfield. Other phases will include expansion towards San Francisco, which the terminal has already been built, Union Station and San Diego. However, we as capybaras can do better. Let's kick it up a notch. Imagine extending the network beyond California. Picture hopping on a train in Los Angeles and riding all the way to Phoenix, Las Vegas, or even Tijuana. Phoenix. Tying one of the fastest growing cities in the US to California could ease highway congestion and foster economic collaboration. And the families that just want to visit Disneyland would get there a whole lot quicker. Tijuana. A cross-border connection could redefine travel and trade between the United States and Mexico. This stop just makes too much sense. After all, phase 2 of the route is going to San Diego, so why not extend it just a little bit, opening doors for tourism and commerce. Again, for people that just want to visit Disneyland. But let's not ignore the elephant or capybara in the room. The challenges. Cross-border rail systems require immense collaboration, from immigration protocols to harmonized infrastructure standards, etc., etc. Picture airport-level security here. When it comes to high-speed rail in the United States, the public sector often takes center stage. But Brightline West is here to prove that private companies can do a good job too. Brightline, already a household name in Florida, has its sights set on the western United States, with an ambitious plan to connect Las Vegas to Southern California. Brightline West's proposed route will run from Las Vegas to Rancho Cucamonga. With stops in Victorville, this isn't just a fun ride from Robert Venturi City to Rancho Cucamonga. It's a game-changing alternative to the infamous I-15 highway. Notorious for holiday traffic jams, at Rancho Cucamonga, passengers will be able to seamlessly transfer to LA's commuter rail system, making it easier than ever to travel between Las Vegas and downtown Los Angeles. Now, Las Vegas tourists are known for making bad decisions, but I imagine most would not make the mistake of driving instead of picking this glamorous train. Brightline West is expected to use Siemens Velaro train sets, built right in the United States at their factory in Sacramento. These trains are not only fast, but also energy efficient and just look great, frankly. Brightline is already changing the perception of rail travel in America. As a private company, they've successfully launched and expanded a somewhat profitable passenger rail network in Florida, connecting Miami to Orlando, again for people that just want to visit Disney World, with plans to extend further. Now with Brightline West, they are showing that high-speed rail isn't just a government project, it's a viable business model. Brightline has a very clever business strategy: real estate. Building profitable apartments and developments near the train stations, a strategy quite popular back in the good old days of railways. Next stop, Texas, Mexico, and beyond. Stay tuned as we explore how to bring high-speed rail to more parts of the Americas. But before that, be sure to click that subscribe button. This is just the beginning. This capybara has a dream and a bunch of videos coming soon. They say everything is bigger in Texas, and what better way to connect them than with high-speed rail? The Texas Triangle, linking Houston, Dallas, San Antonio, and Austin, has long been talked about as a prime candidate for high-speed rail. But let's focus on the most ambitious project in the works, the Dallas-Houston High-Speed Rail, spearheaded by the private development Texas Central. Modeled after Japan's Shinkansen, yes, that bullet train, this project promises to cut travel time between the two cities to just 90 minutes, with speeds up to 240 miles per hour. There are some problems, and by some, I mean a lot. First, the company might not even exist anymore in the future. Secondly, many residents oppose the said high-speed rail construction, which led to many lawsuits. But there is some silver lining, or Amtrak lining. In 2023, Amtrak gained an interest in this project. Quote, Texas Central Partners and Amtrak are seeking opportunities to advance planning and analysis work associated with the proposed Dallas-Houston 205 mile per hour high-speed rail project to further determine its viability. So, there's still hope. Right? What if the Texas Triangle didn't just stop at Texas? Picture this, extending high-speed rail south to Monterrey, one of Mexico's most dynamic cities. For those unfamiliar, Monterrey is Mexico's third largest metro area and a booming industrial and cultural hub. Nestled in the northeastern state of Nuevo León, Monterrey is often called the industrial capital of Mexico due to its strong manufacturing base and international business connection. Its proximity to the US border makes it a natural partner for cross-border commerce and travel. Next, we head to the Gulf Coast. While not fully blown high-speed rail, I propose upgrading the corridor between New Orleans and Texas to bring faster, more reliable service to a region that desperately needs transit improvements. Mexico is no stranger to the idea of expanding railways. With Tren Maya and more coming soon, what if there was more? What if there was a high-speed rail from Mexico City to Guadalajara? This line would connect the country's capital to its second largest city. Mexico to Acapulco high-speed rail would bring passengers to this iconic beach destination and could revolutionize tourism, making weekend gateways a breeze for millions. Building high-speed rail from Texas to Monterrey and throughout Mexico isn't just about speed, it's about connection. Connecting people, different cultures and economies across borders. And let's be honest, who wouldn't love a train ride that comes with tacos, fajitas, and atole de piñón? Let's take a trip through the heart of the South, faster than ever before. Imagine hopping on a high-speed train in Atlanta, a bustling cultural and economic hub, and arriving in Charleston, a fast-growing city. Connecting these two cities would encourage collaboration across industries, from tech, finance in Atlanta, to shipping and trading Charleston. Now let's talk about the Northeast Corridor, or NEC, the busiest rail line in the country. Stretching from Washington to Boston, it's the backbone of America's network, serving over 800,000 passengers daily. But despite its importance, this corridor is overdue for a speed and infrastructure upgrade. With improved infrastructure, modernized signaling, and new rolling stock, the NEC could achieve higher average speeds, cutting travel times dramatically. Take for instance Alstom's Avelia Liberty, the next generation high-speed trains designed to replace the current Acela fleet. With its debut promised to be this year, the NEC will be one step closer to becoming a true high-speed rail corridor, showing the world that America is ready to lead in rail innovation. Hopefully. Next up, we're heading to Detroit, Toronto, and Quebec. Imagine a quick train ride between Detroit and Toronto. This line wouldn't just be a convenience, it would be a symbol of integration between Canada and the United States. You probably see that most of Canada's population lives below this line. Picture a high-speed corridor waving through Canada's major cities, from the cultural hubs of Toronto and Montreal to the historic charm of Quebec City. A high-speed rail network across the US-Canada border is about connecting cities, people, ideas, and different economies. In fact, part of this line I am proposing is being considered by the government, though a much reduced route. Hopefully it will happen before I die. Ah, South America, the birthplace of capybaras, a region with incredible potential for transformative rail project. For those unaware, there is currently zero high-speed rail here, but we are going to change that. Let's start with one of the busiest corridors in the Southern Hemisphere. The high-speed rail line between São Paulo and Rio de Janeiro could cut travel times from 6 hours by car to just 90 minutes by train. This project is currently being planned by a private company called TAV Brasil, or Trem de Alta Velocidade. The current project has 4 stations, São Paulo, Rio, and additionally São José dos Campos. A major industrial city you might know for being the headquarters of Embraer and Volta Redonda. Nothing happens there. If said project happens, it would open by 2032. Yeah, we'll see about that. As you can see, I don't have much hope in this project.
I don't think so. No, 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 no. I don't think so. No, 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 no. It's never, ever, 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 ever gonna happen.
Another project on the works is in Chile. The president of Chile, Gabriel Boric, has announced that the government is ready to upgrade the Santiago-Valparaíso route to 187 km per hour. This is all fine and dandy, but what if it was bigger? Chile's long, narrow geography is perfect for bringing high-speed rail. A line from Santiago to Antofagasta could connect mining regions with urban hubs, boosting economic efficiency. Crossing the borders in the Andes, we could link Lima, Peru to La Paz, Bolivia, with a potential higher speed connection to Chile. Argentina currently has one of the best rail networks in South America. But what if it had high-speed rail? Imagine linking between Buenos Aires, Rosario, and Córdoba, creating a high-speed triangle of economic growth. Argentina already has a very good inner-city rail service, probably the best in terms of length in South America. In Argentina, you can actually go places in a train, unlike in Brazil. However, what if there was more? A line between Buenos Aires, Rosario, Messi's hometown, and Córdoba would be the crown jewel of this rail network. South America has the heart, the landscapes, and bustling cities ready for high-speed rail. And as a continent where capybaras roam, however, building high-speed rail would not be easy, not because of technical or geographical troubles, but because of political instability. Infrastructure projects take years to plan and build, requiring long-term political stability and funding commitments. In many South American countries, frequent leadership changes and economic crisis can derail even the best laid plans. Large-scale projects like high-speed rail often come with high costs, and issues like corruption can result in a subpar product for double the cost. Even capybaras know that building trust is harder than building tracks. But we as Americanos should strive to build a continent for ourselves, a continent connected by high-speed rail. So here's to the future, where high-speed rail is not just a dream. It's a living reality.